Hello viewers, so welcome to my channel. I'm Hashim Ali Khan. So now in this video, I'm going to take up the new topic called consignment accounts under the subject financial accounting 2. Already in this financial accounting 2, the chapters which I've completed, I have uploaded all the videos in my playlist. The chapters like bills of exchange, joint venture, accounts from incomplete records, and accounts for not-for-profit organization, non-trading concerns. So all these, the topics I have covered, I have prepared so many videos and uploaded in the playlist. So if you have not watched those topics, I suggest you to go to the playlist of my channel. Select the subject financial accounting 2. In that, you will find all these subjects. Joint venture, bills of exchange, accounts from incomplete records, accounts of not-for-profit organization. Select the video. Watch the video, definitely you will get a lot of knowledge, a lot of command on those subjects, on those topics. Now in this video, I'm going to explain you about the meaning of the term consignment. Then what are the features of this consignment? Then what are the differences between sales and consignment? What are the differences between pro forma invoice and account sales? Then what is the accounting treatment in the books of the consignor and in the books of the consignee? That means what are the accounts they will prepare and what are the journal entries they will pass, consignor and consignee. All these things I'm going to explain you in this video. So this is the foundation for the problems. Don't take it easy, this chapter, this video. Watch till the end, because if you are strong on the theory, then definitely you can easily understand the problems. The problems are based on the journal entries which I'm going to explain you in this problem. So watch the video till the end, then only you can understand the problems. So first of all, I'm going to explain you the meaning of the term consignment. To consign means to send. Consign means to send. But in accounting terminology, consignment means it's a special method of trade, special method of trading in which one person will send the goods to another person to be sold on his behalf and at his risk. That means A, send the goods to B. B has to sell the goods and remit the amounts to A. That means B is acting as an agent of A. So two parties are there. One person is sending the goods and the other person is receiving the goods and selling the goods and remitting the amount to the sender. That is called consignment. It's simply like principal and agent. A is the principal, B is the agent. A will send the goods to B. B has to sell the goods and remit the amount to A. That is called consignment. The person who sends the goods is called the consignor. And the person who receives the goods is called the consignee. The relationship between the sender and the receiver is of principal and agent. So what the agent has to do, what the consignee has to do, he has to, sell the goods, receive the amount, deduct his expenses, deduct his commission, and the remaining amount he will pay to the sender, that is consignor. By sending the goods, the consignee will not become the owner. It's not a purchase. He's not purchasing, but is simply getting the possession of the goods. The consignee is getting only the possession of the goods. His job is to sell the goods, get commission. He is not doing work freely. He is working on behalf of A for commission. His remuneration is commission. So normally in this consignment process, normally the consignee will also send some advance to the consignor. Some advance to the consignor. So after receiving the advance, the consignor will send the goods later on. When he sells the goods, the consignee will sell the goods, he will incur some expenditure. So from the sale proceeds, he will deduct the advance sent, he will deduct his expenditure, he will deduct his commission, and the remaining amount he will remit it to the consignor. This is called consignment. So simple words, a consignment is a process in which one person will send the goods to another person the other person has to sell the goods and remit the amount to the sender, that is consignor. The consignee is doing the work on behalf of consignor for commission. He will get commission. Commission will be calculated on the as a percentage on sale proceed. Normally commission is calculated as a percentage of sale proceed. Now, by receiving the goods, he will not become the owner. The risk is on the head of consignor only. That means as long as the goods are not sold, it is remaining with the consignee. The risk of the goods is on the heads of the consignor. Because consignee is not the owner. Ownership is still with the consignor only. The consignee is having only a possession. So the risk attached on those goods will be of the consignor, not of the consignee. Now, the consignor will send the goods. At the time of sending the goods, he will prepare an invoice. That is called pro forma invoice, not an invoice. Not an invoice, it's a pro forma. Pro forma means just like an invoice. So invoice, pro forma invoice is a statement which is prepared by the consignor at the time of sending the goods. In this pro forma invoice, the consignor will specify the quantity, the price, and the description of the goods. Only these things will be specified by the consignor to the consignee at the time of sending the goods. And periodically, as the goods are sold, periodically the consignee will make a statement called account sales. And this account sales periodically will be sent by the consignee to the consignor, explaining how much value of goods sold, how much advance he has paid, how much expenses he has incurred, how much commission he is going to get. All this after deducting the net amount remitted by the consignee to the consignor will be written in this statement called account sales. So I have completed. Meaning of the term consignment, I explain you. Consignor, the person who sends the goods. Consignee, the person who receives the goods on behalf of consignor. Then pro forma invoice, it is the invoice which is prepared by the consignor and sent it to the consignee, explaining the price, quantity, and description of the goods at the time of sending the goods. Account sales is a statement which is periodically sent by consignee to the consignor, explaining all the details of sale proceed. Now, differences between sales and consignment. In examination, very frequently a theory question may also be asked regarding all these things. A short question may be asked, what do you mean by account sales? A short question regarding what do you mean by pro forma invoice? And what is consignment? Explain the features of consignment process. So whatever I have explained, that will be more than enough. Now, differences between sales and consignment. Many differences are there. First difference regarding the ownership. In case of consignment, the goods are transferred, but ownership is not transferred. The ownership is still retained with the consignor. Consignor is only sending the goods, not selling the goods. That means consignee is getting the possession, not the ownership. That is the case in case of consignment. But in case of sale, as soon as the goods are sold, the ownership will be transferred from the seller to the buyer. That is the first difference. Second, return of goods. Normally, in case of consignment, consignee can return back the goods to the consignor because he has now become the owner. At any time, he can return back the goods to the consignor. But in case of sale, goods once sold will not be taken back by the seller. Until and unless it's a defective goods or there is a mutual agreement that the seller has agreed to take back the goods. In that case only, if there is specific agreement or defective goods, then only it can be taken back. Otherwise, in sale transaction, goods once sold will not be taken back. Next is mutual relationship. What is the relationship between consignor and consignee? The relationship is that of agent, principal and agent. Principal and agent. Consignor is the principal and consignee is the agent. That means whatever instructions given by the principal, same instructions have to be followed by the agent, consignee. So mutual relationship, the relationship between consignor and consignee is that of principal and agent. But in case of sale, the relationship is of seller and buyer. That's it. Next, risk. In case of consignment. The risk of the goods which are unsold is on the head of consignor. The consignor has sent the goods to the consignee. As long as consignee has not sold the goods, it is still remaining unsold, then the risk of that goods is on the hand of the head of the consignor. If something happened to the goods, the loss should be borne by the consignor, not of the consignee, because consignee is not the owner. He is possessing the goods, he is not the owner. So the risk lies with the consignor. But in case of sale, as soon as the goods are sold, the ownership is sold, the risk is also transferred. As soon as the goods are sold, the risk of the goods is on the head of the buyer, not of the seller. Once the goods are sold. Next is sales expenses. All expenses, whether it is paid by the consignor or expenses paid by the consignee, all expenses should be borne by the consignor. All expenses, whether it is paid by consignor or whether it is paid by the consignee, all selling expenses should be borne by the consignor. But in case of sale, the expenditure incurred after ownership is transferred will be borne by the buyer, not by the seller. The seller has sold the goods to the buyer. So any expenditure to be incurred on the sale, on the goods, should be borne by the buyer, not by the seller, because he has sold the goods. So all other expenses should be borne by the buyer. Next one is payment. In case of consignment, the payment will be made only when the goods are sold by the consignee. As long as the goods are not sold by the consignee, there is no need of any payment to be made by the consignee to the consignor. The payment will be made only on the sale of goods. But in case of sales, the payment has to be made immediately at the time when the ownership is transferred, when the goods are sold. Next is invoice. In case of consignment, they will not prepare invoice, because invoice is a document which is prepared only when the ownership is transferred. In case of consignment, no ownership is transferred. So a statement called pro forma invoice will be made. Pro forma invoice, just like invoice, but not a real invoice. So pro forma invoice will show the price, the description, the quantity of goods sent by consignor. Whereas in case of sale, actual invoice, a genuine invoice will be made by the seller and given to the buyer. Next is account sales. In case of consignment, time to time, periodically, as the goods are sold away, the consignee has to make a statement called account sales. In this account sales, he has to specify what is the sale proceed, how much advance he has already given, how much expenditure he has incurred, how much commission he is to get. He will deduct all from sale proceeds and the net amount now remitted to the consignor. All these details will be written in the account sales, periodically made by consignee and sent it to the consignor. Whereas no account sales is required in case of sale transaction. Next is commission. In case of consignment, the consignee is working on behalf of consignor for commission. His remuneration is commission. He is putting the effort in selling the goods, so he is entitled to get commission. So commission will be calculated as a percentage on sales normally. But in case of sale transaction, no commission is there, only discount. Only discount may be given by the seller to the buyer. Discount may be given by the seller to the buyer at the time of sale, but there is no commission. So these are the differences between sale and consignment, very frequently asked in examination theory question. So whatever I have explained, if you listen, watch once or twice, you can be able to write. Next is differences between pro forma invoice and account sales. Very frequently another theory question asked. Both are different documents prepared by different parties. First is pro forma invoice sent by consignor to consignee, whereas account sales sent by consignee to consignor. First difference, which document is prepared by whom? First of all, pro forma invoice is a document which is prepared by the consignor and send it to the consignee. Whereas account sale is a periodical statement explaining the details of sales prepared by consignee and sent to the consignor. First. Second, pro forma invoice gives description of goods sent. Whereas account sales give description of goods sold. Send and sold. The pro forma invoice, which is prepared by consignor, will explain the goods regarding the goods he is sending. When he sends the goods, he will explain about the price, quantity, description, that's it. But account sales will be prepared by consignee when the goods are sold. As long as the goods are not sold, no account sales will be prepared. Next is pro forma invoice sales sent only once when the goods are sold, whereas account sales are sent periodically. Only once pro forma invoice will be prepared and sent by the consignor to the consignee. But account sales will be prepared periodically, like every month or every fortnight, every 2 months. Like this, account sales will be sent by the consignee to the consignor. Next one is pro forma invoice does not make consignee responsible to pay the amount stated therein. Whereas account sales make the consignee responsible for the amount stated therein. When pro forma invoice explains the price, it is not compulsory that the same price, at the same price it is sold. That means he can change it. In pro forma invoice, he has just stated, the consignor has stated that you can sell the goods at so and so price. Not, it's a must. He can change it with mutual understanding, he can change it. But in case of account sales, whatever he has specified, that must be complied with by the consignee. Next one, pro forma invoice does not serve as basis for making entries. While making journal entries, while recording the transactions, pro forma invoice will not be taken as a base. Whereas account sales can be taken as a base in recording the transaction. So these are the differences between pro forma invoice and account sales, very frequently asked in examination. Accounting treatment. Now, what are the journal entries? What are the accounts to be prepared in the books of consignor, consignee? So first of all, I'm going to explain you books of consignor. The consignor is the owner of the goods. So what are the accounts he will make? Four accounts you would remember. The first account, consignment account. Briefly, I'm giving the explanation of each one of the account, then I'll go to entries. Consignment account. The consignor is interested in knowing whether he is getting profit or loss on each consignment. It is not necessary that one person, a consignor has appointed only one consignee. He has appointed different consignee. For example, presently, A city, city A is the city of consignor. A is sending the goods to B, C, D, E. This B, C, D, E are the different consignees located at different places. Now the consignor is interested in knowing how much profit I am getting from each of the consignment. So he cannot mix up all the consignment. Every consignment should be kept separately to find out which consignment he is getting the profit, which consignment he is incurring loss. So to find out the profit or loss on each consignment, a separate account is opened called consignment account. It is a nominal account. All expenses will be debited, incomes will be created. So what are the items that will be debited to consignment account? Goods sent, cost of goods sent on consignment, expenses incurred by consignor, expenses incurred by the consignee on commission payable to consignor, consignee, commission payable to consignee. All the expenses will take on the debit side of consignment account. And credit side, sale proceed. At what price consignee has sold the goods and what is the value of the unsold stock? Unsold stock with the consignee. The two items you remember on the credit side sale proceed and value of unsold stock on consignment. These are the two items on credit side. Debit side, cost of goods sent on consignment, then expenses incurred on consignment by the consignor, expense incurred on consignment by the consignee and commission on the consignee. All these things will be debited. Now, we have to compare the total of debit side and credit side. If credit side is more than debit side, the balance is the profit on consignment. The balance is profit on consignment. That profit will be transferred to profit and loss account. If credit side is more than debit side. Suppose if debit side is more than credit side, it's a loss. And this loss will also be transferred to profit and loss account. That's all. This is consignment account. Next is consignee account. The consignor will open an account of consignee also to find out how much is the amount due from consignee. It's a personal account. It's a personal account. So this consignee account will be debited with the sale proceed. With the sale proceed, at what amount he sold the goods, that will be debited. And credit side, his advance paid, if he paid any advance. Secondly, expenses consignee might have incurred, commission due to consignee, all these things will take it on the credit side. And the balancing figure is the balance remitted by consignee to the consignee. So it's a personal account. Consignee account is a personal account. Then third one is goods sent on consignment account. It's a real account. Goods sent on consignment account is a real account. This account is credited by goods sent on consignment. By consignment. The entry will be consignment account at to goods sent on consignment. So this account is credited by consignment. And finally, the amount will be transferred to trading account or purchase account. Last one is consignment stock account. It is also a real account. It is a value of the goods which is remaining unsold at the hand of the consignee. So when the accounts are closed, at that time, some stock is unsold in the hands of the consignee. So we make an entry for this unsold stock. The entry will be consignment stock account data to consignment account. So these are the accounts which are maintained by the consigner. What are the accounts maintained by the consigner? Consignment account, consignee account, goods sent on consignment account, and consignment stock account. That's it. Now I'm coming to the main point, journal entries. What are the journal entries to be passed in the books of the consigner? See, all the problems are based on these journal entries. So if you want the confidence on this topic of consignment, if you want to be perfect on this topic of consignment, remember, full concentration is required. You have to remember the entries, journal entries. What are the journal entries? Each entry I'm going to explain you. First, journal entry in the books of the consigner. First entry. For goods sent on consignment, imagine A is the consigner, B is the consignee. Now A is sending the goods. A is sending the goods. As soon as he sends the goods, the entry will be consignment account data to goods sent on consignment. First entry, when the goods are sent by consigner to consignee, entry will be consignment account data to goods sent on consignment. Being the goods sent on consignment to the consignee. Narration. Just now I got one comment, query from one of my viewer. He wants to know whether narration is compulsory. Yes, of course, narration is compulsory. I'm not writing here because time will be wasted, but I'm explaining. For every entry, a narration is required. So here, when goods are sent by consigner to consignee, entry will be consignment account data to goods sent on consignment. Being the goods sent on consignment. Second, for expenses. For expenses incurred by consigner, the entry will be consignment account data to bank. A is the consigner. While sending the goods by A has to spend some expenses like freight, cartage, or insurance, etc. So these are the expenditure incurred by A, consigner. The entry will be consignment account data to bank. Remember, two entries were. Consignment account data to bank. For advance given, sometimes the consignee may give advance to the consigner before selling the goods. A will ask B that I am sending 1 lakh rupees worth of goods to you, but right now you pay an advance of 50,000. Later on we deduct from the sale proceed, but right now you have to pay advance 50,000. So if advance is received in the form of bank, in the form of check, so we write on bank account data to consignee account. Who is the giver? Consignee is the giver. So bank account data to consignee account. Sometimes a bill of exchange, a bill is received. Bills receivable account data to consignee. If check is received, bank account data to consignee. If bill is received, bills receivable account data to consignee. But this entry will be there only if advance is received. If no advance is given, no need to pass this entry. Next, if the consigner gets the bill discounted with bank. Suppose A has got the bill, bills receivable from consignee. After receiving this bill, he got the bill discounted with his banker. He need immediate money. A has received 50,000 rupees bill from consignee. Now immediately he want the money. He can take the bill to the banker to get it discounted. Banker will say, okay, 50,000 rupees is the face value of the bill. We will pay you 49,000 right now. 1,000 rupees you have to allow discount. The entry will be bank account data, discount account data to bills received. Remember, these two entries will be not be not in every problem. If it is given that advance is given, then only we pass this entry. Next entry for settler, for the sales made by consignee. We got the information from the consignee that he sold the goods. B has given the information that I have sold the goods for ₹1,20,000. As soon as he got the information, he will pass the entry consignee account data to consignment account. He got the information. So who has actually sold the goods? Consignee has sold the goods. So entry will be consignee account data to consignment account. Then for expenses incurred by consignee, some expenses will also be incurred by the consignee in selling the goods. Then for that expenses, consignment account will be debited. Consignment account data to consignee account. See here, some expenses are paid by consignor, some expenses are paid by the consignee. When consignor pays the expenses, it is called consignment account data to bank. When expenses are paid by the consignee, the entry will be consignment account data to consignee account. Next entry, for commission payable to consignee. Now commission is due to consignee, entry will be consignment account data to consignee account. Same entry for expenses incurred by consignee, consignment to consignee. For commission payable to consignee, consignment account data to consignee. In both these cases, the entry is same. Consignment should be debited, consignee should be credited for expenses incurred and also for commission due to consignee. Next, for consignment stock. So at the end of the period, there is consignment stock. So what is the entry for consignment stock? Consignment stock account data to consignment if there is unsold stock with the consignee. Next, for profit on consignment. After making all these entries, we'll make the consignment account to find out whether there is profit or loss. If credit side is more, there is a profit. The entry will be consignment account data to profit and loss account. Consignment account data to profit and loss account. If debit side is more, there is a loss. Entry will be reverse. Consignment account data to profit. Profit and loss account data to consignment. So if profit is there, profit and loss account should be credited. If loss is there, profit and loss account should be debited. Profit raha to P&L account credit side. Loss agar ho gaya to P&L account debit side. Now for closing the goods sent on consignment. So every time goods sent on consignment should be closed by transferring it to purchase account or trading account. The entry will be goods sent on consignment account data to trading account. So every year goods sent on consignment account should be closed by transferring it to trading account. For remittance from consignee, final amount received from the consignee. Final amount received from the consignee. The bank account data or bills receivable. If we get a draft or check, we debit bank. If we get a bill, we debit bills receivable to consignee account. That's it. So these are the journal entries to be passed in the books of the consignor. In the books of the consignor. All the problems are based on this entry. So watch these entries twice, thrice, four times. Then only you can be able to solve the problem.